I'm not alive. sorry, that's the wrong page. Hang on. I got it. I'm good. Ladies and gentlemen, we're gathered here today in the presence of God with family and friends to join together this man and this woman in marriage. Marriage is a covenant of faith and trust between a man and a woman, established within their shared commitment in the covenant of faith in Jesus Christ as our Lord. Therefore, it requires of both man and woman openness of life and thought, freedom from doubt and suspicion, and commitment to speak the truth in love as they mature in their faith. Marriage is a covenant of hope that endures all things, in which both husband and wife commit themselves to interpret each other's behavior with understanding and compassion, and to never give up trying to communicate with each other. Marriage is a covenant of love, in which both husband and wife empty themselves of their own concerns, take upon themselves the concerns of each other, in loving each other just as Christ loved the church so much, so that he gave his life for it. Therefore, this covenant is not to be entered into lightly, but with great thought and respect for the magnitude of the commitment being made. With this in mind, Hunter and Jessica have come today to make this covenant with each other. Who gives this bride to be made? I ask you now in the presence of God and these people to declare your intention to enter into marriage with one another through the grace of Jesus Christ. Hunter, will you have Jessica to be your wife, to live in the covenant of faith, hope, and love according to God's intentions for your lives together? Will you listen to her innermost thoughts, be considerate and tender in your care of her, and stand by her faithfully in sickness and in health, preferring her above all others? Accept full responsibility for her every necessity, as long as you both shall live. And Jessica, will you have Hunter to be your wedded husband, to live together in the covenant of faith, hope, and love, according to God's intention for your lives together? Will you listen to his innermost thoughts, and be considerate and helpful in your support of him, and stand by him faithfully in sickness and in health, preferring him above all others, and accept full responsibility for his every necessity as long as you both shall live? For those of us that know Hunter, we may be surprised that they finally got here. But for those of us that know Jesse, we know why he stands here. It's an honor for me to be a part of this day. Thank you guys so much for giving me this privilege. And before I proceed much further, I want to take this opportunity to just share a little bit of wisdom with both of you. Many people grow up believing a fairy tale of finding their true love and their true soulmate. And when they find this one person, all of their dreams will come true. Well, I want you to understand that this story is exactly what it's presented to be. It's a fairy tale. It's not a truth, and it's not a reality. The truth is that no one's perfect person, there's no one perfect person out there for you. You make decisions, much like we make decisions in our life, God gives us free will. We have the option to choose. And you guys have chosen each other. Marriage is what you make of it. And you get out of it what you put into it. You may have heard the expression, the grass is greener on the other side, but I want to challenge you with a clearer statement of that. The grass is greener where you water it. The only way that you will have a successful marriage is for you to be intentional about investing in your relationship. You have to constantly invest in and fight for your marriage. I pray that today starts the dawning of a beautiful chapter in your life, and I strongly urge you to always be intentional about investing in your relationship with each other. Let divorce never be an option for you. Murder maybe, but never divorce. It will take work from time to time, and you will change as you grow older. But if you do this right, there will be few things that will be as rewarding for you in this lifetime. Hunter, God instructs you as the head of your home to love your wife as Christ has loved his church, a selfless love that gives place to no others, a sacrificing, supporting, providing, encouraging, and passionate love. And Jessica, God has called you to honor your husband, to be his helpmate, to encourage, to build up, to comfort, and to exhort him, to be passionate towards him in a selfless and faithful love. The two of you are to always view each other as a gift, for you are God's gift to each other. You are to bear one another's burdens. You are to care for each other, to invest in dreams, passions, and the desires that each of you have. You are to defend each other and pray for one another. Be careful to never lose the passion, awe, and the love that you have for each other in this moment. And now, Hunter, please repeat these vows to Jessica. I, Hunter, take you, Jessica, to be my wife. To have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health,
to
love and to cherish until we are parted by death. This is my vow. Justin, let's repeat these words to Hunter. I, Justin, take you, Hunter, to be my husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until we are parted by death. This is my vow. The wedding rings are an outward symbol and a visible sign of unending commitment and an unending love. They're symbols to yourself, to your spouse, and to the world that you vow to love each other without end. Let's pray. Father, bless these rings so that Hunter and Jessica may live committed to each other. As they seek you, may they walk in your peace and in your favor all the days of our lives, their lives. In Jesus' name. May this beautiful token and pledge symbolize the endlessness of your love. And as you do, Hunter, repeat after me. Jessica, I give you this ring as a sign of my vow. And with all that I am, with all that I have, I honor you, and I commit to loving you for all my life. Place that on his finger. Hunter, I give you this ring as a sign of my vow. And with all that I am, and with all that I have, I honor you, and I commit to love you for all my life. The two of you have declared your covenant and your vows before God and those gathered here today. May God bless your marriage. Now that Hunter and Jessica have given themselves to each other by vow and the giving of rings, I announce to you that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man take apart. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce to you Mr. and Ms. Hunter Davis. Thank you. Thank you again so much for joining us on this awesome occasion. The wedding party is going to go do some photographs, and we're going to have a reception right over here in just a few minutes, so I encourage you guys to hang around and party with a happy couple.